Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Soumi and thank you so much for stopping by. If you are someone who has a sweet tooth and can never say no to sweets yet try to eat healthy, then today's video is for you. Today I'm going to share a quick healthy cookie recipe with you which is free from any flour, refined sugar and it is vegetarian. This recipe is loved by my 2.5-year-old and he calls it mommy cookie. If you like this recipe, please don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe button. So without further ado, let's get baking. For our wet ingredients, I will take 3/4 cup of jaggery sugar into which I will put 1/2 cup of ghee. You can also do this recipe with 1/2 cup of virgin coconut oil and then 2 teaspoons of vanilla essence. I now whisk this mixture with the help of a whisker. You can also use an electric mixer. For dry ingredients, I will start with 2 cups of almond flour. I am using fine almond flour, to which I will put 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of pink Himalayan salt. You can also add in a lot more flavors like cinnamon powder, or if you want to add a little Indian tadka to it, then maybe with some cardamom powder like 1 teaspoon. But those are all optional ingredients and I will just keep it simple. You can also add in chocolate chips, dark chocolate chips, raisins or any nuts of your choice. For me today, I will just keep it simple. Once I have put all the dry ingredients, I will mix with a spatula. Now I will bring back my wet ingredients and put all my dry ingredients into the wet ingredients. With the help of a fork, I will mix these two together. Now remember that this dough will not be extremely tight. It will be a little bit in the crumblier side because it does not have any flour or gluten. Yes, it is gluten free. So don't be scared. It will still hold together once you start to form the cookies. So mix them well until it forms like a sand or wet sand texture. Now this is what my dough will look like. I will take a tablespoon and then scoop out some dough and then press it a little on my baking sheet. I have these silicone baking mats from Amazon. I can link it down below. I bought it like few years back, but you can also use parchment paper and that will work absolutely fine. Now again, 1 tablespoon is a little small for me. I like my cookies a bit bigger size, hence I will just directly take, you know, eyeball the size of my dough of each cookie. I will make a ball of it, put it on the baking tray and then pat it down to spread it a bit. Now remember, these are not the usual gluten cookies, hence it will not spread on your baking tray a lot. So you can kind of crowd the cookies in the baking tray, on the baking tray, just make sure you leave a little room in between two cookies. Now this dough will fetch you around 15 to 17 cookies depending on the size that you desire. I have already kept my oven to preheat at 180 degrees centigrade. I will bake them at 180 degrees centigrade between 12 to 14 minutes. Make sure that you check after 12 minutes because every oven is different. So here comes the moment of truth. Look at these cookies, like what vibrant colors. I just love the smell in my house right now. So while the cookies are still warm, I will shift them from my baking tray and put them on the rack so that they completely cool down. And once they cool down, only then you can shift them to your storing jar. Move them into an airtight container. Hope you like this recipe. Please do try this at home and let me know your comments in the comment section below. Hope to see you guys soon next time. Bye bye, take care and stay safe.